Maurice Beniowski. Count Maurice Beniowski de Benyó et Urbanó, Hungarian, Beniowski mate Móric Mihály Ferenc Szerafin Ágost, Polish, Maurycy Beniowski, Slovak, Móric Beňovský, September 20, 1746, May 24, 1786, was a renowned military officer, adventurer and writer from the Kingdom of Hungary, who described himself as a Hungarian and a Pole. He is considered a national hero in Hungary, Poland, and Slovakia. Beniowski was born and raised in Verbo, Kingdom of Hungary, present-day Verbove, Slovakia. In 1769, while fighting for the Polish armies under the Bar Confederation, he was captured by the Russians and exiled to Kamchatka. He subsequently escaped and returned to Europe via Macau and Mauritius, arriving in France. In 1773, Beniowski reached agreement with the French government to establish a trading post on Madagascar. Facing significant problems with the climate, the terrain and the native Sakalava people, he abandoned the trading post in 1776. Beniowski then returned to Europe, joined the Austrian army and fought in the War of the Bavarian Succession. After a failed venture in Fiume, present-day Rijeka, he traveled to America and obtained financial backing for a second voyage to Madagascar. The French governor of Mauritius sent a small armed force to close down his operation, and Beniowski was killed in May 1786. In 1790, Beniowski's posthumous and largely fictitious account of his adventures, entitled Memoirs and Travels of Mauritius Augustus Count de Beniowski, was published to great success. Biography. Beniowski's autobiographical Memoirs of 1790 makes many claims about his life. Critics from 1790 onwards have shown that many of these are either false or are highly questionable. Not the least is Beniowski's opening statement that he was born in 1741, rather than 1746, a birthdate which allowed him to claim having fought in the Seven Years' War with the rank of lieutenant and having studied navigation. The following biographical account includes only those facts which are, or could yet be, corroborated by other sources. It should also be noted here that, although Beniowski freely used the titles Baron and Count for himself throughout his memoirs and in correspondence up to 1776, he was never a Baron, his mother was the daughter of one, and he only became a Count in 1778. Early years. Maurice Beniowski was born on September 20, 1746 in the town of Verbo, present-day Verbove near Trnava, Slovakia. He was baptized under the Latin names Matthias Mauritius Mihal Franciscus Serafinus, Hungarian, Mate Móric Mihály Ferenc Szerafin. The additional name Augustus, Ágost, may also have been given, but this is not clear on his baptismal record. Maurice was the son of Samuel Beniowski, who came from Turek County in the Kingdom of Hungary, today partially Turek region, in present-day Slovakia, and is said to have served as a colonel in the Hussars of the Austrian army. His mother, Rosalia Rive, was the daughter of a baron from the noble Hungarian Rive family. She was the great-granddaughter of Peter Rive, and the daughter of Count Boldis Rive de Sklabina. When she married Samuel Beniowski, she was the widow of an army general, Joseph Pest Varmija, d.1743. Maurice was the eldest of four children born to Samuel and Rosalia. He had one sister, Marta, and two brothers, Ferenc, 1753, and Emmanuel, 1755-1799. Both brothers followed military careers. In addition, there were three stepsisters and one stepbrother, born to Rosalia from her previous marriage, Teresia, 1735-1763, Anna, B., pre-1743, Borbala, born 1740, Peter, born 1743. Maurice spent his childhood in the Beniowski mansion in Verbo and studied from 1759 to 1760 at the Pieris College in St. Georgi, present-day Svatiger, a suburb of Pressburg, present-day Bratislava. When both his parents died in 1760, the family home and estate was the subject of litigation between the two sets of siblings. Marriage and military service. In 1765 Beniowski occupied his mother's property in Russo, present-day Rusov, near Verbo, which had been legally inherited by one of his stepbrothers-in-law. This action led his mother's family to file a criminal complaint against him, and he was called to stand trial in Nitra, present-day Nitra. Before the conclusion of the trial, Beniowski fled to Poland to join his uncle, Jan Tibor Beniowski de Benyó, a Polish nobleman. His flight violated a legal edict forbidding him to leave the country. He was arrested in July 1768 in Sepes Sombat, present-day Spišská Sloboda, a suburb of Poprad, present-day Poprad, in the house of a German butcher named Anch for trying to organize a confederation of bar militia. Shortly after his arrest, Beniowski was briefly imprisoned in the nearby Stará Lubovna castle. At around this time, he married the daughter of this butcher, and a Zuzana Anch, 1750-1826. A child, Samuel, was born to this marriage on December 9, 1768, d. Poprad, September 22, 1772. Three other children later came from this marriage: Charles Maurice Louis Augustus, b. 1774, Madagascar, d. July 11, 1774, Madagascar, Rosa, b. January 1, 1779, Bicsko, Hungary, d. October 26, 1816, Vieska, Hungary, Zsófia, b. after 1779. Prisoner of war in Siberia. This period of Beniowski's life has only been documented by Beniowski himself, in his autobiographical memoirs. There exists no independent verification of his life in the period between July 1768 and September 1770. In July 1768, Beniowski traveled to Poland to join the patriotic forces of the Polish-Lithuanian Commonwealth, who had organized resistance in the Confederation of Bar, Konfederacja Barska, a movement in rebellion against Polish King Stanislaw August Poniatowski, lately installed by Russia. In April 1769, he was captured by the Russian forces near Ternopil in the Ukraine, imprisoned in the town of Palin, before being transferred to Kiev in July, and finally to Kazan in September. An escape attempt from Kazan brought him to St. Petersburg in November, where he was recaptured and sent to the far east of Siberia as a prisoner. In the company of several other exiles and prisoners, most notably the Swede August Windblad, and the Russian army officers Vasily Ipanov, Asaf Baturin, and Ippolit Stepanov, all of whom played a major role in Beniowski's life in the next 2 years, he reached Bolsheretsk, at that time the administrative capital of Kamchatka, in September 1770. Escape from Kamchatka. Over the next few months, Beniowski and Stepanov, along with other exiles and disaffected residents of Kamchatka, organized an escape. From the list of those who participated in the escape, 70 men, women and children, it is evident that the majority were not prisoners or exiles of any sort, but just ordinary working people of Kamchatka. At the start of May, an armed uprising by the group overcame the garrison of Bolsheretsk, during which the commander, Grigory Nilov, was killed. The supply ship St. Peter and St. Paul, which had been overwintering in Kamchatka, was seized and loaded with furs and provisions. On 23rd of May, old style, 12th of May, the ship set sail from the mouth of the Bolsha River, and headed southwards. Beniowski's memoirs state that the route taken by the ship, having rounded the southernmost point of Kamchatka, was generally north and eastwards, taking in Bering Island, the Bering Strait, Alaska and the Aleutian Islands. However, in the time available, 4 weeks according to Beniowski's own account, this 6,000-mile itinerary is barely credible for a leaky ship and inexperienced crew. Such a route is completely absent from three other separate accounts of the voyage, by Ippolit Stepanov, Ivan Ryuman and Gerasim Ismailov. Additionally, some of the events described by Beniowski are so implausible that the entire voyage in this area must be considered a fiction. The ship landed at the island of Simushir in the Kuril Islands chain, and stayed there between 29 May and 9 June to bake bread and take stock of their supplies and cargo. During this time, the sailor Ismailov was judged to be organizing a mutiny. He and two other Kamchatkans were left on the island when the ship finally sailed southwards. Ismailov subsequently carved out a career as an explorer and trader in the Aleutians and the Alaskan coast, providing information to Captain James Cook in the summer of 1778. Their next known port of call was at Sakinahama on the island of Shikoku in Japan, where they rested between 19 and 23 July, and in the following days at Oshima Island in Awa Province. Here the voyagers managed to trade with villagers, despite this being expressly forbidden by the Japanese authorities. At the end of July, they landed on Amami Oshima in the Ryukyu Islands, where they also traded successfully. At the end of August they arrived on the island of Formosa, present-day Taiwan, probably at Black Rock Bay, where three of the voyagers were killed during a fight with native islanders. Then they sailed to the Chinese mainland, at Dongshan Island. Following the coast down from there, they finally arrived at Macau on September 22, 1771. Shortly after their arrival in Macau, 15 of the voyagers died, most likely from the effects of malnutrition. Beniowski took responsibility for selling the ship and all the furs they had loaded at Kamchatka, and then negotiated with the various European trading establishments for passage back to Europe. In late January 1772, two French ships took the survivors away from Macau. Some of them, 13, stopped on the island of Mauritius, others died en route, 8, and the remainder, 26, landed at the French port of Lorient in July. First expedition to Madagascar. Beniowski managed to get a passport to enter the mainland of France and he departed almost immediately for Paris, leaving his companions behind. Over the next months, he toured the ministries and salons of Paris, hoping to persuade someone to fund a trading expedition to one of the several places he claimed to have visited. Eventually, he managed to convince the French Foreign Minister de Guillon and the Navy Secretary de Boines to fund an expedition of Beniowski and a large group of Beniowski volunteers to set up a French colony on Madagascar. This expedition arrived in Madagascar in November 1773 and were fully established there by the end of March 1774. They set up a trading post at Antongil on the east coast and began to negotiate with the islanders for cattle and other supplies. It does not appear to have gone well, since the explorer Kerguelen arrived there shortly afterwards to discover that the Madagascans claimed Beniowski was at war with him, supplies were therefore hard to come by. A ship which called in at Antongil in July 1774 reported that 180 of the original 237 ordinary volunteers had died, and 12 of their 22 officers, all taken by sickness. A year later, despite reinforcements, personnel numbers were still dwindling. Beniowski's memoirs state that a son, Charles, was born to him and his wife Anna at some point during 1773 or 1774, and that the son died of fever in July 1774, though this is not verified anywhere else. Despite these setbacks, over the following 2 years, Beniowski sent back to Paris positive reports of his advances in Madagascar, along with requests for more funding, supplies and personnel. The French authorities and traders on Mauritius, meanwhile, were also writing to Paris, complaining of the problems which Beniowski was causing for their own trade with Madagascar. In September 1776, Paris sent out two government inspectors to see what Beniowski had achieved. Their report was damning, little remained of any of the roads, hospitals or trading posts of which Beniowski had boasted. Beniowski's own journal of events upon Madagascar suggests great successes against the recalcitrant people, who eventually proclaimed him to be their supreme chief and king, Ampansack Abe. However, this sits at odds with his own reports, and those of the inspectors, of unceasing troubles and minor wars against those same people. In December 1776, just after the government inspectors had departed, Beniowski left Madagascar. Following the arrival of the inspectors' report in Paris, the few surviving Beniowski volunteers were disbanded in May 1778 and the trading post was eventually dismantled by order of the French government in June 1779. Europe and America. After leaving Madagascar, Beniowski arrived back in France in April 1777. He managed to be granted a medal, Order of St. Louis, and considerable amounts of money in back pay, and lobbied the ministers for more money and resources for a different development plan for Madagascar. When this plan was turned down, he then petitioned Empress Maria Theresa of Austria for a pardon, for having fled Hungary for Poland in 1768, and made his way to Hungary where he received the title of Count, a title he had been misusing, along with Baron, for several years before. In July 1778 he joined the Austrian forces fighting in the War of the Bavarian Succession, in which his brother Emmanuel was also fighting, and then in early 1780 he formed a plan to develop the port of Fiume, present-day Rijeka, as a major trading port for Hungary. He was here until the end of 1781, when he abandoned the project, leaving behind several large debts. He then made his way to the United States and, with a recommendation from Benjamin Franklin, whom he had met in Paris, attempted to persuade George Washington to fund a militia under Beniowski's leadership, to fight in the American War of Independence. His brother Frank was also at that time in America, fighting as a mercenary against the British. Washington remained unconvinced, and Beniowski then returned to Europe, arriving in Britain in late 1783. Here he submitted a proposal to the British government for a colony on Madagascar, but was again turned down. Instead, he managed to persuade the Royal Society of London luminary Jean Hyacinthe de Magellan to fund an independent expedition. In return, Magellan received full publishing rights over the manuscript of Beniowski's memoirs, and the grand title of European Plenipotentiary for Beniowski's new trading company. In September 1783, Beniowski also acquired a document signed by Emperor Joseph II of Austria, which gave Beniowski Austrian protection for the exploitation and government of Madagascar. Second expedition to Madagascar. In April 1784, Beniowski and several trading partners sailed to America, where a contract was agreed with two Baltimore traders, Zollicoffer and Messenia. The deal was for monetary investment in return for a regular supply of slaves. In October of that year, the ship Intrepid sailed from Madagascar, arriving near Cap Saint Sebastian in northwest of the island, June 1785. Here the expedition was met with aggression from the Sakalava people. Beniowski and a number of others were captured and disappeared, presumed dead. The surviving members of the company sailed for Mozambique, sold the ship and dispersed. In January 1786, however, Beniowski was reported to be alive and operating at Angonsti, near modern-day Mboitraulanana. Anxious about another disruption to trade, François de Souillac, the French governor of Mauritius, waited for fair winds and then sent a small military force over to Madagascar to deal with Beniowski. On 23 or May 24, 1786, Beniowski was ambushed and killed by these troops, and was buried on the site of his encampment. Most biographies cite 23rd of May based on the statement by Beniowski's 1790 editor William Nicholson, but French sources documented by Prosper Culture cite 24th of May. Legacy. Much of what Beniowski claimed to have done in Poland, Kamchatka, Japan, Formosa and Madagascar is questionable at best, but in any case has left no lasting traces in the history of war, exploration or colonialism. His legacy resides largely in his autobiography, Memoirs and Travels of Mauritius Augustus Count de Beniowski, which was published in two volumes in 1790 by Friends of Magellan, who was by then, as a result of the failed Madagascan venture, in serious financial difficulties. Even at the time of the first publication of the book, it was met with significant skepticism by reviewers. Despite this criticism, it was a great publishing success, and has since been translated into several languages: German 1790, 1791, 1796, 1797, Dutch 1791, French 1791, Swedish 1791, Polish 1797, Slovak 1808, Hungarian 1888. The Kamchatkan portion of Memoirs was adapted into a number of successful plays and operas, plays by Kotzebue 1792, Vulpius 1794, operas by Bewaldew 1800 and Doppler 1847, which were performed in suitable translation all over Europe and America. The Polish national bard Juliusz Słowacki published a poem about him in 1841. More recently, films and television series have been made, a Slovak-Hungarian TV series in 1975. Vivat Beniowski, director, Igor Ciel, a documentary for Hungarian TV in 2009, Beniowski Morik S. Malgasak Volja, director, Zaltsi Ezik, and the Hungarian film Beniowski, The Red Bull Count of 2012, director Arena Stanciulescu. In Hungary, Slovakia and Poland he is still celebrated as a significant national hero. A Hungarian-Madagascan friendship organization promotes the links between Beniowski and Madagascar, arranges conferences and other meetings, and maintains a website dedicated to the celebration of Beniowski's life. The Polish writer Arkady Fiedler visited Madagascar in 1937, spent several months in the town of Mbananilo and later wrote a popular travel book describing his experiences. In it, he gives a romanticized version of Beniowski's career. Fiedler appears to have made an effort to find out if Beniowski was still remembered by the island's people, with mixed results. In fact, his name did survive in Madagascar. In recent years, a street in the island capital Antananarivo was renamed Lalana Beniowski. Notes/citations. Further reading. External links. Further reading. External links. Further reading. External links.